one.
Time auto resume. Okay, we're live. We're live, auto resume. Got my light on low beam. So I was thinking maybe Sacred Grounds. Tonight, that's what I was thinking. Traffic out. Thank you. to me. Cars on the right. MCA, I wanna go to the why not MCA. Battery I've got left tonight either. Didn't bring my batteries in. Charged them last night. I got preoccupied. Oh, let's go through the woods. Come on, let's do it. Let's go through the woods. Let's see what we got. Yeah, I got preoccupied. I had a leaky water line in my bathroom I had to fix last night. I was up till, heck man, almost 11 o'clock working on that. So, by the time I realized I hadn't brought my lights in, that was slick. It was almost time for my ride. If I remember correctly, yesterday there was another offshoot somewhere that I had thought about taking. There's a fence, so I can't get through there. That belongs to somebody. Was that it there? No. Or was it? I don't know. Now if it comes back up this way. Or does it? Oh, maybe I should turn around. Can I get down there? Oh, that was my spot. That was my spot, man. These things just kind of sneak up on you. You know, you look through the brush and you don't see an opening, then boom, there's one right there. And if you don't take it, it's gone. I think I remember going this way. Yeah, I came around this side, come up the other way, on this way. So, yeah, this is the way I came up. So now, we're gonna go back this way. Still a little mushy. Oh, time is not auto pause, I'm still moving. You dummy. Nope, I've come out this way before. Let's get up the hill. That wasn't very fun. There's one way in. There's the other way in. Let's turn around. Time is not auto pause. I've gone in that way and come out that way. See, I don't want to get lost back there. There's a spot I just came out of. I want to get in that thing and not come out until I pop out either in a neighborhood or on another side of town or something. I don't see another way in from here. Nope. So let's go to Edwardsville. I was gonna go to Redco or Starbucks, but I've been doing that the past couple nights. I don't know what's down this field. I think that's just a house. That just goes to a house. Yeah, nothing exciting over there. Don't want to ride through that brush with my good pants on because I'll come up full of stickers. Yeah, I'm whining about coming out with stickers. I'm a baby. You sit down one night and you pick those things off of your clothes. You won't go in the I'll go through them with sharp pants on because, well, I comb the hair on my legs and they'll come out. And I'm usually pretty sweaty. I don't want to tackle that thing, it's still a little damp. Even though, clean up after your pet. sunset. That'd be good for stringing a hammock between the swing set poles. Doing some stealth camping. Oh heck, there's houses over there. Would have to be very stealth. Going down. And there's an abrupt ending to the road. Let's see if we can get some light up. Not a bad little park, huh? I'm not gonna jump the curb going back up, but I don't know how late the restrooms are open. But when you're stealth camping, the world is your oyster. Or your restroom. Start doing manned missions to Mars, you know, tourist stuff, or even the moon, I don't care. Outer space, I say outer space. Riding the continental divide, yes. Yourself terminally ill. Kind of gives you a little boost to keep fighting. Don't call hospice just yet. I'm not going to let this butt boil bring me down. I still gotta go to Fred Winter's Park. And then, once you check everything off your list, you go, oh well, that's it. Time to die. Thank you. bike list so you have it notarized and filed at the recorder of deeds office at the courthouse. And they don't let you touch it. Car's coming? Nope. Or I got something in my, I thought I heard leaves or a stick in my drivetrain. Or do you have to make up stuff to do while you're still able-bodied? Or you had to put things on there that you can only do if you're feeble and weak. Let's say you're 60 years old. Now, you get your ass kicked, and that might be your bucket. I'm in a ring with some dude who's half your age. That may be the only thing on your bucket list, and the last thing on your bucket list. Or do you set meager goals? Simple, obtainable, meager goals. Like winning a game of bingo. G7, bingo! What the hell? He just died. Yeah, well, that was his bucket list. Man got bingo and he died happy. So I've got a lot of questions about this bucket list. Guys, I never saw the movie, so I don't know what this consisted of. But judging by the previews, I think part of the premise was to it. Then they go out and they fulfill their bucket list. I think it's supposed to be one of those feel-good movies. You know, you go out and you're old and dying, soiling yourself, having seizures because you can't get your medicine at regular intervals. Taking that last hurrah out of life. Act like a kid again. ride a bull. Go work on an offshore oil rig. Something crazy. Any cars coming? We got this. To me, all of that's crazy. Still going Edwardsville. Just say hello to my little loop that I haven't taken for a few days. I normally make a left on. So live life to the fullest. The world's not built that way. Sorry, description of mankind to somebody who could ever invent concepts such as live life to the fullest. For that very reason. Because if you recognize the world for what it is, you would either disappear into substance abuse, depression, despair, despondence, nothing would get done. Sit around bemoaning the insignificance of this existence. The only factories that would be open are the ones that make razor blades for slicing your wrist, rope for making nooses to hang yourself, or guns. every now and then, these little witticisms of feigned hope are uttered. Hang in there, baby. It's almost Friday. You ever see that kitty cat? Hang in there, baby. Live life to the fullest. Carpe diem. Seize the day. Baby on board? No, that's not one. But you get the drift. We have to create a desire to survive.